And I sympathize with you. Because you've been given the more difficult task. And I appreciate you.
No, not just that, I'm sorry for taking your time, but Ahmed and I are on the record for, on public record for having taken your side on, in paper and on paper.
So I really appreciate you for making the best arguments that you could for a terrible case. It's a debate, and we do need to honestly look at all sides of it, and the best minds need to put forth the very best arguments that they can for a really bad case. Yes? And the really bad case that they're making is that it was all in national interest for a state to capitulate to 1,500 people in Hyderabad. This is a state that my worthy opponents will tell you in another debate, or maybe in the next sentence, is nuclear. Hum sar tod jawab denge. Hindustan ka. Yehudiyon ka. Lekin 1500 galgiyon ka nahi. They are arguing to you that a national interest was served by my heart breaks by making your and my representatives by the representatives of 200 million people rubbing their noses in the mud, getting them to bow down to 1,500 militants. Listen, guys, why don't all of us, we must be about 100 here, let's gather 1,900 more. Let's go down to Faizabad. All of us, unout, and do dharna. And then see how this state beats you and me back. Let's just see how even just this weak government beats us back. What was it that allowed those 1,500 people to beat down an entire supposedly state? Tell me, 1,500 aadmi, usko usne Pakistan ki sari police force ko maar diya, interior minister, law minister, tuflana par dhamaka. And this is supposed to be excellent. Its place in the scheme of things. And what does my name? What is the scheme of things? The scheme of things is that there is a permanent government in this country, which is the elephant in the room. And it beats down every, I'm not talking about PMLN, I'm not talking about just PPP, I'm not talking about the what are the new kids in town? you see the thing is they're popular in certain sort of segments of society right now. If they actually really become popular, they will also become the target of the deep state. The point is, showing down popular representation. That is what it has always been about. My and your national interest is not served by a ragtag army of 1,500 or 1,200 or 2,000 people bringing the entire supposedly state down. No. Let's now begin to differentiate. They did not cow down the state. There is a state within the state that cowed down popular representation, that cowed down administration, that cowed down governance, which is those are the people that we have a contract with. We have a contract with the civil government, with the people that we people that we vote for. Those were the people whose noses were rubbed in the ground. Is that in your interest or my interest? These are the people who run the police. These are the people who run everything. Policemen were made to run off, their heads were broken, their eyes were snatched out, and that's in our national interest. On the 6th of October,
Did this elected government that we owe our civil rights to and all, did it oppose that particular?
We don't owe it to them.
No, okay, we don't. But did it oppose this particular thing? It sought the military's help and it asked the military to jump in.
Beta, is he?
That's the point of order. That's the point of order.
Listen, it's a 70-year history.
No.
We all know who calls the shots.
Agreed.
And point of order, whatever. Point is
information.
This government had been told, if you remember, by the Islamabad High Court, it was forced. It was trying to not let a repeat of other things happen, you know? So Islamabad High Court had ordered it to remove these people. So it went ahead, fell in the trap, tried to remove the people. It was trying to ward off these people. When they tried to remove them, what happened? Unknown, Namaloom Afraad, in their thousands, appeared to support the Maulvi crowd.
I'm sorry, are you making these assumptions as facts? Like, do you have something to show for it? Like, that Na Malum Afraad showed up to help the Maulvi Hazrat?
Is there
like any factual basis for saying this?
Yeah.
Any factual basis? Any governmental document, any judgment of the High Court, this matter was taken up? We have three court judgments on the breakage of East Pakistan.
Hamood Rahman Commission report
was by the then sitting Chief Justice of the Lahore High Court. We can't make assumptions and present them as facts. I'm sorry. It's a point of order. It's also kind of like
I have taken your question and I respect your question. Look, there have been several, one after the other, news reports about how the police was beaten back. Do you think that I'm making things up? Do you think that these policemen, when it was reported that they were beaten back and their eyes were taken out, just at around the time that they were going to control the situation, they were reported in the news? There has been no commission to do fact-finding yet, right? So I cannot quote you a fact-finding commission, but you know the news reports, you know the live coverage, all of it is there. And tell me, a point I raised slightly earlier was, if 1,500 of us went there and we challenged the government, what would happen? Would you and I not be beaten the shit out of? No, if we had no backing, if we had nothing behind us.
Another point of order, just a small point of order, with the permission of the chair. If anybody in this
demanded, and it was agreed that there would be a board that would be constituted to do fact finding within 30 days and take action against the government. And that take action against, and this board would be made up of clerics. There was so much, separate agreement was also made with the Punjab government. Is such a strange occurrence. It all gets, and there is the answer to your question. It all gets arbitrated by General, what's his name?
Bajwa.
No. Bajwa was praised. The other general, what was
his name? No.
General Faiz.
General
Faiz.
DGC.
Right? Then you tell me. And then you tell me that there was nobody behind these people. Then you tell me that the state had no will, the government had no will. The point is, there is a general on the point. He signs off on the agreement. He gets, you say it's not even, ye to sumeh de liya thi? Was there give and take? No. The government was made to rub its nose in the mud. It was humiliated. It was beaten back. By whom? Can you and I, 1,500 people, do it?
No.
When General Faiz, zero. When General Faiz, especially not when General Faiz arbitrates this, when he praises General Bajwa, and when he distributes ₹1,000 to each member of that hooliganous crowd, shall I rest my case? It was in the national interest.